Good morning and welcome to another episode of Summer Enrichment Workouts. I'm Coach Fogelsong. Today I'm joined by Coach Palma and Coach Thibodeau. We're going to go through a quick warm-up and then we're going to get right into the main activity today. Today you will need a deck of cards. Make sure you go ahead and take out the jokers and all the rule cards. If you don't have cards, a regular playing deck, you can always use Uno cards, Skip-O cards, any kind of game you have at home, or you can just write out the numbers. 1 through 10, Jack, Queen, King, and an Ace on pieces of paper or note cards, and that will suffice as well. So if you need to step away to grab those cards, make sure you do it now, or you'll have an opportunity during our water break. So we're going to turn some music on. We're going to go through a quick warm-up, holding each exercise for about 20 seconds. So DJ, can we get some warm-up music? And then we're going to start with trunk twists. So these are just easy twists, again, side to side. Without music, I'd be humming. I hum songs to myself without any kind of music. And y'all don't want to hear me hum because I'm tone deaf. Okay, arm circles going forward, just the little ones for the first 10 seconds. And then larger. And then going backwards, the small ones. Y'all can see Coach Palma's on a 10 already today. He is energized. He ate sweet food he's not supposed to be eating in the morning. Then backwards. During today's workout, Coach Palma, because he's so energized, he will be doing all our exercises full out, while Coach Thibodeau is going to be helping with the modified version of exercises. Okay, now to the shoulder stretch. So take your arm, pull it across your body. Like I gotta dance to the music. Left arm across your body. You're like Coach Palma back here. You're doing the sprinkler as you're doing it. Coach Palma keeps us laughing, y'all. Okay, right arm up. We're gonna do the tricep stretch. So pull it behind your head at the elbow. Or dab. Okay, left arm. Make sure you breathe through these stretches. Just slowly bringing our heart rate up and getting our body ready to move. Okay, now the pike stretch. So pike is when your feet are together. We are gonna stay standing up today instead of getting on the ground. So you're going as low as you can. This does depend on your flexibility. So if you're stuck here, that's fine. You can get all the way down, do what works for you without being in pain. Okay, standing straddle. Feet should be a little wider than shoulder width. We'll start with the right leg first. Same thing on all of these stretches. As far as you can go without injuring yourself, but making sure that you're filling a pool. Coach Palma's ready to hit the splits back here. Okay, to the middle. Hand to the left. Okay. Okay, bring it back up. Standing calf stretch, you're gonna lean back on your left, right foot out, toes going up towards the ceiling. So your left leg is supporting you, your right toe is going up to the ceiling. You should feel it in your calf and in your hamstring. Remember, you wanna try to keep a straight back. So it's here instead of being like this. You should be looking at the floor about 6-7 feet out in front of you. Neck shouldn't be pulled up or curled down. Left. So you're gonna, this time you're gonna prop up on your right. Left foot out, left toes towards the ceiling. Our awesome coworkers are fueling up right now to jump in on the second activity with us. Okay, quad stretch, one of my favorites. Grab your right leg with your right hand. You have to balance yourself out. Use a dog, a chair, sibling, a wall. Some people feel like holding their ear, arms out. And left foot, left arm, left foot. When you're doing this stretch, you should always try to keep your knees as close to as possible together and always use the hand on the same side as your body. You don't want to crisscross. Put unnecessary strain on the knee. This is usually my, and I have got balance today. Well, kinda. There we go. And last but not least, one of my favorites, we're gonna do the neck rolls. So we're gonna go from right to center to left, and then we'll go back forward again. I personally don't like going backwards, so I usually keep my rolls half moons to the front. Okay, shake it out. Go ahead and go grab your water. Get a sip before we start. Grab your game cards if you don't have them quite yet. And then join us back in about 15 seconds. Welcome back. I hope everybody grabbed at least their two sips of water and that you've gotten your cards and you're ready to play our first game today. So our first game is called High-Low. In just a second, a graphic will be popping up on the lower part of the screen, and it's going to show you what each of the suits mean on the exercises for today. So, of course, you have, try to put it where you can see it, diamonds. Diamonds, as you can see on the graphic, are squats. You have spades. Spades are for sit-ups. Clubs for push-ups, and hearts for jumping jacks. Next to that, it tells you how many you do for each. If it is a numbered card, so 2 through 10, the number of exercises is the number on the card. So if I pull a six of spades, I'm gonna do 6 sit-ups. If I pull a face card, which is jack, queen, or king, they're all worth 10. You'll just have to pay attention to the suit. So if I pull a 10 of hearts, I have 10 jumping jacks. If I pull an ace, that is the best because that is 1. And I know these helpers today are very tired because this is our 4th video of the day. So they're going to try to get as many aces as they can. So the first game is high-low. I've already set out 15 cards on the lines on both sides of the gym. This is going to be based on the honor system as we're doing this. We're not going to have someone checking their answers. We're going to just know that they're doing what's right. They're both going to start on this end of the line. They're going to flip over their first card. If their first card is a 3, they don't have exercises just yet. They have to decide from there, is the next card going to be higher or lower? So let's say that Coach Palma flips this first card over and it's a 3. Well, we'll just say what it is. Go ahead and flip it over and then I'll switch it. So he got a 2. So then he's going to say, is my next card higher or lower? What do you think?
think it is higher.
So he says higher. He flips it over. And he is correct. It was higher. It's a five, I believe. A five. Now, let's say we don't want him to go any farther because we want to make sure he's doing exercises in a second. But let's say he decides that the next one's lower, and then when he flips the card, it's actually higher. He's going to use that graphic and do those exercises before moving on. So if he says he just had a five, let's say he says it's lower. The next one he flips over is a jack. We'll say a jack of hearts. That means that he's going to have to do 10 jumping jacks before he's allowed to flip over the next card. So each one, they're guessing if it's higher or lower. If they're correct, they keep going. They're trying to be the first one to finish at the other end of the line. There's 15 cards laid out on both sides. If they are incorrect, they have to do the exercise each time. Remember that if you're ready to go full out today, you're going to be watching Coach Palma. He's going to be doing his exercises on this side of the red line. If you're modifying, you're going to be following Coach Thibodeau, and she's going to do her exercises on this side in just a second as well. So that way you can kind of see what they're doing. Let me flip his second card over so he's not cheating. There we go. DJ, can we get some music? And go. So Coach Thibodeau was correct. She guessed lower. So now she gets to jump over to the next card. Ooh, and she was correct.
Nine of push-ups.
There we go. Now, Coach Palma was incorrect. He guessed lower and it was higher. If it's a tie, keep going. So now Coach Palma has to do his 9 push-ups since he was incorrect before he jumps to the next one. Coach Thibodeau's on a roll over here, y'all.
Oh. Yeah, Palma.
So now Coach Thibodeau guessed lower when she had an 8. But the next card was higher with a king. So that means now she has 10 push-ups. Coach Palma forgot to guess. He was so excited, so now he has to do the exercise anyways. Coach Thibodeau's on a roll. Oh, yeah? There we go. She about to win.
Higher.
Oh. There we go. Coach Palma has the plyometric push-ups going on over here. We don't know where that came from. That's what happens when you're extra. It's okay. I'm extra today too, because I realized on camera how amazing my eyebrows look. They look great. So we're all a little extra. That's why we get along. Ooh. It's okay, because Coach Thibodeau already beat you. So yay, Coach Thibodeau. Look at this great sportsmanship. Clapping hands back there. Coach Thibodeau was on a roll on high low. I think she only did like 3 exercises. 2 exercises. Coach Palma kept forgetting to guess the card before he started. So go ahead and flip those over. And in just a second, they're gonna swap sides. Oh. Ha 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 ha. Yes, so they're gonna switch sides. This time we're going from the back end towards the front. Again, remember this is on honor system. So if you're at home doing it and you don't have someone to go up against, you can go ahead and time it with them. Let's see if you can beat Coach Thibodeau and Coach Palma. I don't know, Coach Thibodeau pretty good though. Here we go, on your mark, get set, go. The first one doesn't matter, remember. There we go. So what, did you guess lower though, right? Yeah, that's good.
Yeah.
Coach Palma just pointed out something important. We said that jack, queen, king are worth 10. So if you pull a 10, that's still under a face card. Hopefully you can hear me over Coach Palma back here.
One of eight. Squat. Hey!
One, two. You can skip that one then. If you get two cars that are the same, you can just skip it. But we're going to have Coach Palma go ahead and finish his exercises. Great job. Great job. Six, seven, eight, nine, and 10. Great job. Now they're going to need some water after that. So we're going to take another quick water break. When you come back, we'll need our cards again. However, this time, they're gonna be spread out in the middle of the circle, so you'll wanna spread all 52 cars out with the numbers of the faces towards the ground where you can't see them, and have about 10 feet of running room, 10 feet of moving room. So try to get that done over this water break, and we'll see you in just a few seconds. And welcome back. Hope you went ahead and grabbed your couple sips of water. Y'all see Esther Coach Palma back there again, y'all. Okay, so as you can see, I've already thrown out all 52 cards. They are face down. You want to see only the tops of the cards. And again, this can work with any kind of playing cards. If you have Uno cards out here, that's perfectly fine. You may have to change up the exercises a little, but any kind of playing card will work. So this is called deck, because it's a card deck, deck sure size. Okay, so what they're going to do in just a second, we have two teams. Coach Garcia and Coach Shanks have also joined us. So we're going to have Coach Thibodeau and Coach Garcia on one team, Coach Palma and Coach Shanks on the other team. One at a time, they're going to race out to the middle, pick up a card, take it back to their partner. Once they cross the black line, the partners together are going to do the exercises that are on that card. So in just a second, the graphic will pop up on the screen again so you know what exercises it is that you are doing. We did the spades for sit-ups, hearts for jumping jacks, clubs for push-ups, diamonds for squats. They'll do those exercises together. The next person runs out and grabs their card, takes it back. Again, the partners are going to do the exercises. They're going through it as fast as they can to get as many points as they can. At the end of the game, it doesn't matter who has the most cards. It matters who has the most points. So let's say that Coach Shanks and Coach Palma are like super lucky. They get all the face cards and the tens and nines. They may have less cards than Coach Thibodeau and Coach Garcia, but they could still potentially win. So you're going as fast as you can to get as many cards as you can. We may stop at a certain time, depending on how tired they start looking, because we are working very hard today. Otherwise, you would go until all 52 cards are picked up. So here we go, y'all ready? On your mark, get set, go. So Coach Shank has a four of clubs. So they're gonna do four push-ups. Coach Thibodeau got the six of spades. So they have six sit-ups. Notice they waited till they got behind the black line. The partners did it together. Then the next partner's running out for their card. On these, you can modify. Remember, never push yourself so hard that you're going to hurt. Either during the exercises or immediately after. The nails worked that time. Two jumping jacks. If you need to modify these sit-ups, you can always do a curl-up or have something propping your feet. Put them under a couch. Have your brother or sister sit on them. Do something that allows you to have a little assistance. Jumping jacks, you don't have to jump. You can always just put the foot out. Push-ups, you can be on your knees. And then squats, just not going as low or having assistance to help you pull yourself back up. So go, feel free to use the modified version if necessary. You also have the option of wall push-ups. So if it gets harder as you keep getting on and off the ground, maybe you're working out with a parent that's older, maybe you have an injury, you can always use the wall. In fact, I'll ask Coach Thibodeau next time to demonstrate a wall push-up when she runs back there. Thibodeau, on y'all's next push-up, can you do wall push-ups? Sorry, boy. So they can kind of see what they are. Y'all see Coach Palma cheating? Coach Palma's a sore loser. We're gonna go for one more minute. One more minute. It's a good little workout. They aren't even running that far. But it's a lot of quick exercises. This is a great game to play with your friends and the other students that don't like to run, because they're automatically going to get those lower points, but they're going to be working hard the entire time. 30 more seconds. They're working on their six packs. I moved off camera. There we go. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5. 4, 3, 2, 1. This is each group's last card. They're gonna finish the exercise and then they're gonna count up their points. We got wall push-ups. Remember, that's perfectly fine. She's still using her upper body. The farther out your feet are, the more effort, the more you're having to work the upper body. Coach Garcia and Coach Thibodeau, I know you can't see their cards, but they are actually grouping them to make it easier, so all the 10s together and multiplying. What do y'all have? 20, 30, 40, 50. That is 40, 50, 60, 70.
79, 81, 85.
Oh, they beat them by 2 points. We have 85, 83. So great job. There are no losers. We are just going to high five, say good job, and then bring it back to the middle for a quick cool down. You can. Here, I'll assist you up. I got you. I got you, Coach Shanks. I would too. A lot of sit-ups, I know that. So we only have a few seconds left. We're not going to go through an actual big stretch today. We're going to go with our breathing at the end. So as your arms going up, you're breathing in through your nose for 4 seconds, and you'll breathe out through your mouth, pulling your hands down for 4 seconds. So here we go. Breathe in. And out. Two more times. In. And out. They're doing yoga moves back here. In. and out. Thank you again for joining us today. I am Coach Fogelsong, Coach Palma, Coach Shanks, Coach Thibodeau, Coach Garcia. We'll see you again next week. Remember, stay safe, stay active, and be healthy. We'll see y'all later.